All right, so we got people sitting out, which we know how we feel about that. That's a fold. I probably could have called there with the queen because of just how many other cards are out there low. Yeah, that was a bad run out, Logan. Okay, so sevens, I'm not going to pair a seven, so that's good, right? Because the sevens are dead. There's a seven there and a seven there, so we have seven, 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 seven. So we're going to go ahead and complete this. Hope these sevens and eights fold. Because we are way ahead of a jack-queen. Caught a six, and they paired their eight. You can't, it's hard a continuation. That is twice you paired. Okay, what do we got here? Let's go around and see who's playing this tournament here. All right, can you hold is sitting out. Let's go ahead and make notes. Who's in and who is out? All right, folding this, sitting out. Can you hold Texas sitting out? Let's see. Can you hold sitting out? King Dumpling sitting out. Sitting out at my table. No one's sitting out at this table, so we have two players sitting out. There is no high, Logan. You lost the hand because you paired everything. You had the well. So Kira is saying she doesn't get it, right? So I'll pull up my, maybe you're on it. Let me see if you're on the stream. So like right now you don't have a good hand, you fold, because you need to have a better hand than that. Let's go to Twitch and see who's on.
I think there's mini games around the city. I think. That's what I played. Anyway.
Okay, so you didn't have a childhood. Great. I played RuneScape.
I played
Pokemon. I can't see what those things are. I do not need two up.
I have a 10. Did I have a jack 10? 10-8? No, I had a 10-9. He had a... No, I had a jack 10. I'll fold that. So Big Papa D just had a king, has a king, and went ahead and called the 2-4. That's not a good play. 2-4-3 is going to win every time, so this should be everybody folded here. This game here. Gotta go watch the game, guys. Sorry. Well, she went from not getting it to getting it. Just keep playing low. Five cards. Look around the table, and if you are lower than everyone, you are off to a good start. All right, I'm gonna go watch the rest of this game real quick, and I'll be back. Thank you.
the coach for the Jets, the offensive coordinator for the Jets, used to be the head coach for.
Ridiculous. Dude, worst players ever. Worst. Who's little pancakes? Who's little pancakes? What's up, little pancakes? Ugh. They're horrible. Yeah, I am telling you that they are the worst. They are the worst. Got 9-8. Hey, 5, good hand. Let's go in here and change what we're doing here. Alright, we need these fours over here, so we can go ahead and raise it and complete it.
Ridiculous. Dude, worst players ever. Worst little pancakes. What's up, little pancakes?
This is week 7, and we are playing some Raz. With an ace up, you want to complete the bet, right? You want to kind of raise it, but they're fine. Of course, Natalie's in third. Come on. Yeah, I got this thing on my neck here. It's
cushion me.
Donk 7. Follow Donk 7. Vimic follow. Cute. Logan. Alright, it looks like just one player is sitting out. Bogan, you want to raise. There you go. I cannot lose. This is my game to win. Those are two great Raz hands. I think Kira, I think you bet there. Yeah, you have to always be betting there. So we're drawn to an 86, so we need the two, we need the ace. I'm looking over, I see two aces. We need some help, so. Max, how did you lose all those chips? You were in first place a minute ago. I'm gonna fold it because I had a pair of threes there. I just don't like that, you know. So we're just looking around the table, looking to see. We might go ahead and just check and see if we can open up another table. Let's see if I can open up another table here. Observe. Where's Natalie at? Let's observe that table. Shoot, Natalie Kruger. All right, we got Nally's table going. We got our table going. You have a great hand. Oh, you got the nuts.
Nuts.
Yeah, you just got the nuts. That's really good. All right, and then I have below me and below me another hand. Alright, Natalie's got the ace there. That's a good raise, right? Look at these no good cards here. So Kruger's in first. Can't believe Denver is that bad.
Oh, you got the nuts.
So we can complete this because we have the five already. We need the ace, but we got the seven already. So we're drawn to a 76. We still got some ace lives. We got some good hands out there still alive. That's a fold. Card brings it in. So what was the only real upset today?
Alright, Natalie's got the ace there. That's a good ace. Good cards here.
Broncos suck.
Can't believe Denver is that bad.
Lost.
Thank you.
got a 7-6 draw here. We need to hit an ace or a deuce. That's not good. I don't know. I'm going to check it, though. Bam. Come on. Don't do this to me. Started really well. If I get knocked out of this, I'm going to sit in the hot tub. Great. I got the 2. I need the 8. I'm going to go ahead and just... He should have raised it. Well, I think I play this one, you know? Oh my goodness. It is really this bad. We got a 4-5-6, guys. That's a good hand. We need the ace. We need a deuce. We already have a 5. I'd like the 8 there. Look at that 6-5 ace deuce. Isn't that crazy? Just catching cards now. Look at her 54 right here. That should be betting this every day, all day. I got nothing. I got a jack 8. Oh, man. Poker Pants is sitting out. Poker Pants has. Sitting out though, I think. The ace looks good. I don't know what Alyssa did. She just blinded out her of a tournament. I don't know if she can even play in the next hand. I think she's just out. I think she's out because she can't even pay the ante, so I think they just remove her from the table. Got a 5-2. Who's gonna knock me out? Well, I don't know what to tell you, you know? Thought I might be able to catch some low cards tonight, but no, can't do it tonight. Swag boss, bet that. I might be able to win this one. Here we go. Come on, nothing larger than an 8. Man, I paired, I had a jack. Jack 9, jack 7. Isn't that crazy? Here. I got 76, it's 1,000. Feel free to call it. Dang it. I might be able to get up there. Bring in. I'm at the bring in over here. Let's go back to this table here. So, I was down like to one big bet, and I just was able to come back a little bit. I got a player sitting now. We got two big stacks here. So we just need to catch some low cards, man. And we're not catching them. So, every time I have to bring it in, it's going to cost us 150. Wow, 85. That's a good bet. Can do this one. 4. Probably shouldn't have called here because of the paired 4s, you know? Definitely can't call now. We need an 8, we need a 5. So I'd like to be looking out here and seeing like 7s and stuff. Queen, man. I don't know why he checks the ace. He must have paired his ace. Alright, now we can go. We're drawn to a 74. Come on, ace 5. Already got a 4. Yeah, gotta do it. Yeah, he had a made hand. Look at him with, look at the 6-5. Gosh, TK, man. Nice, nice, nice. Dang it.
Dang it.
Ugh, that sucked. Sucks, man. No excuses. No excuses. Let's go see what Kruger's up to then. All in here, it's like a raise. Melody 8. I didn't see them play a hand. There's a good raise. Now we're cooking. Hey, well, all the aces are gone. Hmm. Good bet. One of these aces should complete it. Seven, three bets here. Nice. 7-3 deuce looks like a made hand, doesn't it? Seven bullet. Donk. Badges. Yep. Logan Kathleen. She might. Nope, she's out too. The Nathans. Let's go ahead and follow the Nathans. I think it's great. I think you go with it. Five is really strong now, you know.
New Hyundai Kona.
Like this, he says, you have 3 blanking seconds to get out of my car. And I'm like, of course, petrified that we're gonna get killed now. So the guy's screaming and he's like, you get off my property. But I thought he was gonna fire some gunshots. I was so scared. And we're running to our car, which is, you know, a few hundred yards down the street. So finally we get free from the, and I'm like, well, how often does that happen? And I'm fully expecting to hear, well, every couple of years something really crazy like this happens, you know. And he goes, about twice a month. Here it was like, this was a commonish thing. I was like, no, I'm out, bro. That was just one of many random speed bumps on the way to finding the perfect job, which was, you know, poker.
And it was on that fateful night in New York City when Phil was shooting pool at the Mayfair Club that he found himself enthralled by the game of poker.
I remember very distinctly, I was resistant for a while. And then I see this hand and it changed my life. And I said, I want to be in that game. It was my first time to play No Limit Poker. So that first night, I won like $2,000, and I was hooked. And then that was it. Whatever else I was doing in life became subjugated to the concept of I need to gamble more. This is too much fun.
Phil Luck.
After several false starts, Phil Luck finally found his one true calling in life when he happened upon a poker game at the Mayfair Club in New York City.
When I started playing poker around 2000, I remember I said, well, if I'm gonna do this, I wanna check out all the major casinos in the world. If I'm gonna do this, I really wanna like go to where the action is best and just like embrace it, you know? There was Casino Europa in South America. There was the Aviation Club in Paris. There was the Concord Card Room in Austria.
No matter where Phil played, he always wore his trademark hoodie and mirrored shades.
It happened to be a gray, oversized hoodie. I actually found a lot of solace and beauty in the hoodie because there was like a cozy kind of disappearing feeling into the hoodie that accompanied the functionality of it.
He was like one of the first guys in poker that I can remember to actually wear the hoodie and, you know, put it up over his head and put the glasses on while he was playing. So this was really, I think, just to somewhat camouflage his natural eccentricities and probably somebody that a lot of people could read.
He had an eerie resemblance to the FBI sketch of the actual Unabomber, so that nickname stuck a little bit.
10 years solid where I did not, it would be 97% likely I had a hood and shades on.
Yes, Phil has lowered the bar for fashion for poker.
I was doing magic at the World Series. I see Phil, like, lurking behind some guy, like, zoning in again, and I'm like, this prick is following me to figure out how I do my magic. And that night, we went out, him and I had just the most amount of fun you can imagine together.
Diamond!
No, don't do it.
Please!
He knew that I had, like, combed over, and I had traveled all over the place, whatever. He kept trying to get me to come to California to come gamble at Bay 101. And he was telling me numbers that he was winning at this casino that were ridiculous. I was like, look, I just traveled. I went to all
Complete
these casinos
it.
All over the world. No one's making that kind of money in poker right now. It's not happening. And I said, okay, I'm going to come out and for 1 week. And my first day, I won $15,800. And I knew that, like, I think it was God or the infinite universal it, the thing greater than us, was looking down saying, you're meant to be a gambler.
Along with Antonio, Phil quickly began to dominate the San Francisco cash games. So for a change of pace, he thought it would be fun to play in some tournaments. But he never expected how much the camera and the crowd would love him.
Phil Locke. Now in the poker world, they call him the Unabomber.
I would say Phil Locke is the P.T. Barnum of poker.
And he gets up, and he's a shadow boxing here, man.
Because he perceived very quickly that when you go big, you get big.
Oh! Oh! Oh, wow! Beth, look! Can you believe he smacked his face? The crowd is going crazy!
His general affect at the table is part of a cultivated strategy.
You can never put Phil Locke on a hand, right? It's impossible.
Yeah, Seamus.
He's laughing and telling jokes. And
you
this
got a call there.
He may have aces, he may have seven deuces. Who knows?
He's going to raise it. He doubles a bet.
The more it looks like it's just fun and games, the more you should be on guard. Very, very smart guy. He knows exactly what he's doing. He knows exactly how he comes across.
I tell you one thing, if he doesn't win the title, at least he'll walk away from here very buffed.
He's my most favorite guy when he makes the final table on the World Poker Tour to have at the table because I know it's going to be a great show.
King, he did it!
What a stunning turnaround he's left.
He has swung around and won this title.
Phil Locke, our champion of the 2004 World Poker Tour Invitational.
He was more entertaining in that one show as the Unabomber than anybody had ever seen. And I think perceived very quickly that, yes, winning a tournament's good, right? But creating something of a personality that people want to see is better.
That day, the Unabomber won hordes of new fans and one very special leading lady. Who was new to the poker world? Actress Jennifer Tilly.
Dad, I can't see what's going on. I'm with sunglasses. Oh, I think that's good for me.
She was there playing, and she was totally enthralled by the game. And then, you know, she met Phil, and somehow was attracted to him.
I just remember thinking, wow, she's really cute. We were like having some real vibe. It was like cool, and I really thought she was funny as all get out.
What is going on?
What I really wanted was to have her phone number to call her, but I actually thought, oh no, that will ruin it because she'll be like, oh, who's this stalkery kid that like wants my telephone number, whatever. And I actually had a plan. I thought, Jennifer, instead of me giving you my number and having it be like 3% that you call me, why don't you give me your number and that way it's 100% that I call you. So that line trapped her in a little logic circle moment, and she just realized, well, and then she found herself hypnotized just writing down the number. I took two more pieces of paper, I wrote the number down two more times, I put one in my pocket, I found a friend, I said, bro, if I happen to lose this number that I have a copy of in my pocket, don't lose this number, this is very important, I'll tell you later. I gave it to her. I was making sure that for sure, I had now had a number with a friend that was holding on to it, and I explained how important the number was. I had one in my pocket. When I got home, I put one in the freezer. Because I was like, you're not
You're not, if you find a phone number in the freezer, you're gonna be like, why is this number here? You'll be like, oh yeah, it's important. And on our first date, she thought I was insane and it was perfect, so it all worked out because she needed somebody insane in her life.
Yeah, I've got a real edge here.
Take it down, Miss Tilly. Take it down.
I don't know how she's in love with him. How does this happen?
Take it home, baby. Take it home. Come on.
Yeah, she's the greatest thing that ever happened to me. I've never been loved more awesomely by anybody. I mean, family, of course, excluded, because they love you as but whatever. I'm very lucky because, like, I'm just a random guy.
Jennifer Tilly, Phil Locke.
Phil Locke made a memorable TV debut in 2004.
Here we go with a cut.
Yeah, oh, he did it. Look at him. Here we go again.
Crowd going nuts for him.
The crowd chanting Bomber. They love this guy.
And things were only getting bigger and better for the wild card.
It's 2005. It was heads up between Phil Locke and Johnny Chan for the bracelet. And just out of nowhere, Locke just went crazy.
And we talked about earlier. He loves Queens.
Phil Locke in full Unabomber mode now.
The whole time, Phil was saying, Johnny effing Chan, I can't believe it's Johnny effing Chan.
Johnny Chan.
He would get down on the floor in between hands, and he would do sit-ups, and he would do push-ups.
I think it's safe to say none of Johnny's 9 bracelets came in this type of atmosphere, Norman.
And when I first saw Phil Locke, I thought he was like a lounge act. But what I underestimated is that, you know, he's a very, very smart guy. You don't want him.
You need to be betting that. Except he's going to entertain the hell out of you.
Bill
you need
lost,
to be betting
the,
that.
You know, very graciously, but I think it was at that time the highlight of Phil's career.
Phil entertained World Series fans once again in 2008 when he decided to play as someone other than Phil Locke.
That's Phil Locke.
That's Phil Locke. Not quite himself today, though.
He came to day one of the World Series of Poker dressed as an old man. I think he looked like he was 82 years old or something. And it took several hours before someone recognized him.
I would like walk up to people I know, and I would talk with his whatever old man accent I could come up with, and that was really, really fun.
Gigi looks like Hume Cronin in Cocoon.
Colleague of mine sort of nudged me and said, "That's him," and I was blown away.
I think that's an excellent way to show up at the poker table when you're a really well-known professional. I can't believe that people had no idea it was him for so long. I know I didn't.
It was fun to watch. I imagine that the powers that be, particularly on the security side, weren't too happy with the stunt.
And then they made a rule which says you can't get disguised and come in. I was like, whatever, so they changed the rule. So at least I had fun while it lasted. When I was 14 years old, I found a book called The Guinness Book of World Records. In the back of my mind, I always remember thinking, wow, how cool it would be to have a Guinness record, you know? And then I was looking at poker Guinness records for some reason, and there was the Guinness record for the longest poker session ever. It was 72 and a half hours or something. And I remember thinking, wow, I've done a couple 50-hour sessions. It's not too much of a stretch to add another day. I wonder if I could maybe get that record.
So Phil set out to do just that at the Bellagio in 2010. Without any stimulants whatsoever.
I wasn't even taking green tea or black tea or anything. Like, this was hardcore Bruce Lee style gambling. I even hallucinated at hour like 57. The chips floated. They were about a foot off the table, just floating. And I remember in the middle of the hand going, that is cool. And that's what happens when you're up for 3 days straight. Things just float. I remember at hour 90, the feelings of euphoria were so intense that within seconds I could be brought to tears.
Man, he really hung in there, but he was awfully loopy at the end.
Phil, I played for 115 consecutive hours, blew away the record, and if anyone ever breaks it, I would imagine he'd go over and try to break it again.
Phil the Unabomber Locke loves to push the limits of poker or anything he's doing.
Being kind of reckless and crazy.
This is the hand.
Is something
sticks.
That like feels good to do once in a while. I don't know why. Like, it's really dumb. It's probably like one of my huge leaks. I mean, it's a life leak for sure.
But Phil found himself questioning his trademark antics while four-wheeling over sand dunes in 2010.
I'd never really ridden ATVs. there's all sorts of ways to have fun, and one of them is racing and going fast and whatever. And even though it looks sort of dangerous, it's not if you're an accomplished driver. The dangerous part is going on a territory you're not familiar with. You never, ever are supposed to take a route that you haven't taken before at insane speed. Something can just pop up like a cliff or something and ruin your day. And in this particular moment, I thought I had clear sailing. And as I'm coming out, I'm on the sand, now it's all pure sand. I'm like, rah. This was like a sand dune cliff that just, it was like one of those Looney Tune cartoon things. What I was trying to do was push the bike away, and then I was gonna try and roll with the fall so that my body could, you know, it was sort of, yeah. My elbow popped out, I broke my collarbone, I shattered my wrist in like a whole bunch of pieces, and I ended up needing 46 stitches around my eye.
If it had gone slightly different, there would have been a very different outcome and not a good one.
I got really lucky there because I could have been blinded, killed, maimed. There is definitely a guardian angel involved in my life.
But Locke's injuries weren't the only thing he was trying to overcome.
Antonio, he loves to needle. Like, his favorite thing is to needle people. And he loved that Jennifer had a bracelet and I didn't.
Play like a man. Your girlfriend would have bet the time.
She probably would have.
Yeah, for sure she would have.
So in 2010, barely a month after his near-death experience, Locke went to the World Series of Poker Europe and won.
The best part about winning that bracelet was that he was no longer able to make that joke. It was just nice. It was like, oh, I think that was the most value from the bracelet. I think I'm gonna always be a games player. I love games.
I can't take it!
I was having fun while playing, and I realized that even some of my biggest losses, I still enjoy those days. Just, it's like so sick.
I'm not worried about that, I'm just depressed about this 1600. That should be over here.
Once I discovered poker, I was like, oh wow, because it hit all the key tenets of what you're trying to get in life, which was fun, freedom, and fulfillment.
If he bluffed you, it's super rare enough that you did the right thing, yeah. For sure.
As long as you're just asking the questions on how can I get the most out of this one, that's what matters. And that just translates to everything in life.
Previously on High Stakes Poker, Daniel Negreanu made up some of his losses by taking down the legend himself, Doyle Brunson.
I just dumped your inheritance, though.
We saw the infamous poker brat, Phil Hellmuth, take a beating over and over.
What? I'm destroying myself, Fathers.
And it went from bad to worse, with everyone wanting a piece of the Hellmuth pie. Tonight, he'll try to stop the bleeding and the whining.
They won't let me win a pot.
And we'll see if Daniel Negreanu's role stays fresh or goes stale.
I can't beat two aces.
From the Golden Nugget Hotel and Casino in Las Vegas, we're playing High Stakes Poker. AJ Benza here with poker analyst Gabe Kaplan. Gabe, the latest tally in our cash game showed Phil Hellmuth down $150,000, and Daniel Negreanu's made a nice comeback, but is still stuck over $400,000.
Well, for someone who does not play high stakes poker, that would seem like a lot of money. But to someone who plays in these games all the time, that's still a lot of money. And it affects these players' pride and egos, as well as their pocketbooks. We saw what happened after Phil Hellmuth lost one particular hand last week.
1,000, 2,000. He got a four.
If he does it again, he's going to get a timeout. The player showed no mercy and seemed to revel in Phil's misfortune.
Well, Phil's a very gracious winner, and he's a terrible loser. And all these players at one time or another have been the subject of one of his tirades. And why should poker players be above good old-fashioned retribution?
Exactly. Sounds brutal, but you got to admit, it sure is fun to watch.
What's that?
You should place every day. At the Bellagio.
You play No Limit every day.
I'll do that if you come in.
Wow. That's an invitation.
I'm going to come in. You know I'm going to come in, but when I come in, I'm going to bring about $20 million with me.
You know how long the list is going to be, Phil?
It's going to be one heck of a game, yeah.
You know how long the list is going to be.
Anybody wants to get in that game where Phil Hellmuth is bringing $20 million to the table, just call 1-900-555-PHIL.
Damon Agrano raises the $5,000. Jennifer Harmon's already limped in with her ace-queen offsuit.
How much?
You can't limp in every pot. $5,000.
I've got my reputation. I need to hurt some people.
What reputation?
You're not a violent person, Phil.
You got a reputation for being kind of live.
I wouldn't say violent, just misunderstood.
I was live again that last time.
Harmon's up $50,000 for the game.
Jennifer's thinking about whether to raise here.
Oof, that's tough.
She was waiting for you to raise this pot instead of Daniel popping up $5,000 more. Well, let you two fight it out.
So Hellmuth and Chan fold, so to the flop we go with two players. 8-jack-6.
Daniel's flopped a pair of eights with a backdoor flush draw, but Johnny Chan said maybe Jennifer was waiting for Daniel to raise, and that's on Daniel's mind, and he checks.
Yeah, prop. So I don't care about the prop. Not a good prop flop.
Now, Jennifer's also aware that Johnny Chan commented on her conservative image, and it looks like she's going to try and exploit that right here.
Yeah.
Man, Kruger's going to win back-to-back here. Get up to 1780. She was down to...
Harmon bets $8,000.
30.
Gotta make sure I got what I think I got.
Daniel knows what he's got. He just doesn't know what to do with it. And Jennifer is correctly putting Daniel on an underpair to that jack.
Ronald calls. Turn card, another six, pairing the board.
Again, Daniel doesn't know what to do with his hand. Jennifer's going to fire another bullet here.
At a 74.
16,000 from Harmon.
10-7.
Jennifer came to play today.
Yeah.
Look at that. She's got a game face on. I'm surprised she doesn't have some eye black under her eyes here.
And then there were really five.
I have a sick feeling she has aces.
But he calls anyway. River's a deuce.
Now, is Jennifer going to fire that last bullet? Because of their familiarity with each other, Jennifer is reading Daniel very well in this hand.
Absolutely.
Hands are shaking a little bit there. That could be a real shake, or it could be deception. That's what Daniel's thinking. So it happens to be a real shake.
Nice complete.
How much is that?
I think it's 25.
Daniel gives up immediately.
Wow.
You got it.
Like I said, Jennifer came to play today.
Yep, she bluffs her way to a juicy pot worth $86,200.
Jacks full, kings, aces. I feel like it was one of those. Oh, that was a four.
Negrano had mounted a pretty good comeback lately, but he completely misread that hand. But you got to give Harmon credit. She's made a pretty good living playing against men.
It might be the fact that I'm a woman, too. You know, when I play against other women, it's harder for me to read them than it is other men. So it might be that, too. I think it has to do with ego, maybe the male ego that from the start didn't think women can play. Maybe they don't try as hard.
What's she talking about, male ego?
It's ridiculous.
Fallacy.
She's got some nerve.
How's my mustache look?
I feel it's hot. Did you trim it?
A little wax. His Majesty's number four.
Well, Harmon made it look easy in that last hand, like taking candy from a baby. Right now, we're playing one player short. Jerry Buss has stepped away from the table, but the game waits for no one. Action falls to Negrano, who's reaching for chips, and he raises the 2,500 with a 6-4 offsuit.
Again, just looking for action.
Yeah. Todd Brunson calls with ace-4 offsuit, so we're heads up. Flops 10-4 deuce with two clubs.
Both players flopped a pair of fours. Todd has the ace kicker. He checks.
Negrano bets 4,000.
$4,000.
And Brunson raises to 10,500.
He made that raise because he's playing Daniel Negreanu. He knows Daniel's playing very loose now. Todd wants to find out if his ace four is any good.
I call.
And Daniel's probably putting Todd on a draw. Maybe a club draw.
Turn cards, native diamonds. Brunson bets 11,500.
And Daniel says, wait a minute, you're supposed to have a club draw here. What are you betting 11,500 for?
Hey, Lupo, gonna win this.
Looks like it's gonna be enough to get Daniel to lay down his hand.
Yep.
Okay, I will be back.
Negreanu Mux is
that one. All right. Alright, let me get a pen and paper. Be right back. I'll be right out. right down the tournament here. Okay, so I think I'm going to give some people like 0 points, right? Because I didn't see a few people play a hand. And I'm sure they were in, but when I went to check on them, they were disconnected or sitting out. So for Poker Pants, 1585, The Melody 8, and Can You Hold Texas, I'm going to give 0 points. Okay. This is week 7, and that is the limit Raz. Purchased Raz. And we're playing 10/08/2023. Staff, which would be tonight, Justin, Cindy, Natalie again, did very well, she came in 6th, Justin Cole came in 13th, horrible, got knocked out by T. Kennedy, TK, Splash came in 21st. Right. 21 players. -3. It's 21. 7 over here, we'll get 10. 2, 5, 6, 7 here, we'll get 9. And we'll get 8, except for Dumpling, gets 4 points. And then we have a 13, a 12, and 11 points. And the Bounty, which is a $10 gift card. Goes to T. Kennedy. Okay, King Dumpling, 4 points. Big Pop D. Liam Martinez. Foster, 7. Six, 3, 4, 1, 1. Good, of course. All right, who is going to get third place here? Between the antes and the bring in, you already sort of have a lot of money out in the pot, you know. Little 76 action there. That's nice. 7, 6, 3, 2. 7, 6, 5, 3, 2. Yeah, you know, bring in is 320, so. King, king. It's not a good start. Oh, he pairs it though. Ah, look at that 64. Wow. Everything's coming up roses for Lupo. That's third place though. That's a trophy. If you eat bet in here, it's a good bet. All right, going for that first place trophy and a $10 Amazon gift card.
that one. If you got two undercards here, you know, two low unders, you could maybe get away with it. But... it's a good race, good complete. Might be it. This is, it's always a good little start, you know, when somebody brings it in with a full amount. Alright, I think I'm going to go ahead and just end this. I don't see anything, you know, we're just, it'll go back and forth. This is kind of where you got to keep seeing hands. We didn't really cover heads up with a limit game. But, you know, if you had a 2-3 under here, even with a king up, you still would like to want to go with it, you know. Okay, maybe he did. Now he has a 10, though. But a 10-2-3. Alright, well, something was up. Might have pair is two, because now you're at 3,200, and this is a big pot. Oh my gosh, my back is so bad. Now he's just got the nuts here. Can't really call here. So here he has five big bets, right? Five big bets. Man, he's folded a 3-6. Battle. You can come back. This one might be a good one here. Got him. Got him on that one. TK's coming back.
Thank you.
said she can't. The battle. Thank you.
This is the heads up match of all time. The heads up match of all time. Here we go. This is, might be it. I like the 6-3-4 here. Paired the 5. Oh, 6-4-2, look at this. Nice. Got a 10, made the 10. Ah, 64, look at that, nut low. Wow, that was really cool. Wow. That's how it works, that's how you do it. He came back from all the way down to beat Alupo and T. Kennedy. Gets the prize. Gets not only the $10 gift card for knocking me out, and if I couldn't win it, I'm glad he did. He gets the $10 gift card and the trophy. Wow, that's big time. That's a big score right there. That's cool. All right, next week we're moving on to stud. We got a little stud high-low. And how do I get rid of this? This is really... All right, ran the stream. Thanks a lot.